Have you ever gone to bed with a perfect blood sugar only to wake up wondering what happened overnight? You didn't eat, you didn't snack, you didn't even look at a banana, but your morning number is higher than it was when you went to sleep. Today, I'm going to explain why your blood sugar rises overnight, especially if you're living with type 2 diabetes or prediabetes, and what you can do to bring those fasting numbers down naturally. This is one of those topics where once you understand it, everything about managing your blood sugar starts to make sense. Between about 2 a.m. and 8 a.m., your body prepares to wake up. Even when you're asleep, your brain and liver are busy getting ready for the day. They release a group of hormones, things like cortisol, growth hormone, glucagon, and adrenaline. These are your wake up and get going hormones. They tell your liver, hey, we're about to be active. Send out some glucose. So your liver releases stored sugar into your bloodstream to give you a little morning energy boost. That process has a name. It's called the dawn phenomenon, and it happens in everyone. Even people without diabetes experience it. But here's the difference. In someone with good insulin sensitivity, their body quickly clears that sugar from the blood. In someone with insulin resistance, that system doesn't work as well. If you have insulin resistance, which is the root cause of type 2 diabetes and prediabetes, your cells don't respond properly to insulin. Insulin is the hormone that acts like a key to open the cell door. When the liver releases glucose overnight, insulin tries to move that sugar into your muscles and tissues, but the key doesn't work as well. So instead of entering the cells, that sugar stays trapped in the bloodstream. This is exactly what was shown in a 2019 study where researchers found that people with insulin resistance had higher rates of hepatic glucose output in the morning, meaning the liver keeps making sugar even when blood sugar is already high. Now, here's where it turns into a cycle. Because your cells aren't getting enough energy, your body thinks it still needs more sugar. So the liver says, okay, let's help out, and keeps making more glucose through a process called gluconeogenesis. That means making new sugar. It converts amino acids from protein and glycerol from fat into more glucose. This process keeps pushing your blood sugar higher and higher, even though your body already has plenty of sugar floating around. A 2020 paper in Nature Reviews Endocrinology described this perfectly. In type 2 diabetes, the liver's glucose production becomes inappropriately elevated. In other words, the liver's doing its job, but too much of it. Here's the key takeaway. Your liver is just trying to help. It's releasing sugar to get you ready for the day. But because of insulin resistance, your body can't handle that sugar properly. So it builds up in your bloodstream. The good news? We can fix insulin resistance. Decades of research from The Lancet, Diabetes Care, and Nature Communications show that insulin resistance is caused by too much fat inside muscle and liver cells. That fat blocks insulin from doing its job. When you reduce that fat, especially the fat that comes from meat, cheese, eggs, and oils, insulin starts working again. Your fasting glucose drops, your energy rises, and your body becomes naturally insulin sensitive again. So the real question isn't why is my liver making sugar? It's why can't my body use the sugar it already has? You've been told that lowering your fasting blood sugar takes months. What if I told you that's not true? Research now shows that you can see improvements in a matter of days when you use a few science-backed methods that actually target the root cause of insulin resistance. Here are the top ones. Number one, the sunrise eating window. Most people do intermittent fasting wrong. They skip breakfast and eat late, which raises fasting glucose. But studies show that early time-restricted feeding, eating in a 6 to 8 hour window starting in the morning, can lower fasting blood sugar overnight. Why? Because your body's natural clock, your circadian rhythm, is most insulin sensitive earlier in the day. When you eat breakfast at 8 a.m. and finish dinner by 2 or 3 or even 4 p.m., your body burns glucose more efficiently, improves insulin sensitivity, and lowers oxidative stress even without weight loss. Number two, the after meal sponge effect. Exercise isn't just about burning calories, it's timing that matters. Walking for 15 to 30 minutes after each meal can cut your glucose spikes by up to 50% compared to walking once a day. That's because gentle movement activates contraction-mediated glucose uptake. Your muscles literally vacuum glucose out of your blood. Number three, the cellular degreaser. If insulin resistance had a smoking gun, it would be fat stored inside your liver and muscle cells. That fat blocks insulin from doing its job, so sugar can't enter your cells. The fastest way to clean it out? A low-fat, plant-based, whole food diet. In a landmark study published in The Lancet in 1955, Dr. Inder Singh placed 80 people with insulin-dependent type 2 diabetes on a low-fat, high-carbohydrate diet, less than 30 grams of fat per day. Within just 3 to 6 weeks, 63% of patients no longer needed insulin. By 18 weeks, 80% of them were completely off insulin while eating plenty of carbohydrate-rich foods. Even those taking large doses of insulin, up to 120 units a day, reduced their needs by more than half. Dr. Singh concluded, there is no indication that healthy people taking a diet high in carbohydrates are especially liable to diabetes. In fact, numerous observations show improvement of carbohydrate tolerance following its greater intake. A 2025 randomized trial published in Nutrients showed that eating 2 cups of mango per day significantly reduced insulin resistance in overweight or obese adults over 4 weeks without weight change. These modern results align brilliantly with Singh's findings. When you reduce fat inside cells, insulin starts working again. And even a vibrant whole food fruit like mango can support that metabolic healing. Number four, the metabolic reset switch. When you combine these strategies, early eating, post-meal movement, and low-fat, plant-based meals, you trigger what researchers call metabolic flexibility. Your cells relearn how to use glucose efficiently. Your fasting numbers drop and your energy returns, often within days. This is exactly what we teach inside our free Mastering Diabetes training, how to sequence your meals, movement, and daily rhythm so every cell in your body becomes a glucose burning machine. If you want the step-by-step plan that helps people lower fasting glucose, A1C, and medication use, all while eating more fruit than ever, just comment training below and we will send you the link. It's 100% free and it's helped thousands of people see dramatic changes, sometimes in just a couple of days. If this video helped you, hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and share it with someone who is ready to improve their blood sugar. Until next time, keep those carbs high and that A1C low.